Our next delegate is Bogdana Kovac, PhD student from Department of Land and Agrarian Law Yaroslav Mudry from Ukraine. Her topic is land tenure systems and property rights in Canada and Ukraine, the comparative law aspects. Please, Tanjina, stop sharing the screen so we can go further.
Yes, I hope I have already stopped my sharing.
Okay, maybe
okay. Now it's okay. I can see Bogdana. Hello. Okay.
Hello, everyone. My name is Bogdana, of course. Thank you so much for your attention. Today, I would like to present you my presentation about some aspects of legal regulation of land zoning in Canada. As I am a PhD student, and I'm working on my thesis about comparative land law system in Ukraine and Canada. So this topic I found very interesting, so that's why I want to share some information with you. To start with, I want with the term of zoning, which means in Canadian law refers to the processes and management carried out by the authorities aimed at land use, construction of buildings as land improvement. In its turn, we know that in the process of zoning, land is divided into appropriate
zones. Can you please press F5?
F5, just a second. Unfortunately, it doesn't work.
Oh, then you click this presentation here on the bottom.
Uh-huh, yeah, I know, but I have some issues here. Just a second.
Okay, no problem.
Bottom of the page.
Uh-huh, maybe
okay,
something.
No
okay,
problem.
So zoning procedures in Canada are currently regulated by the Canadian Municipal and Planning Law, adopted in 1983. According to the provisions of this Act, zoning in Canada is also considered as control function of the authorities over the proper use of land in municipalities. This law in particular regulates the following main issues. So the first one is how you can use the land. Second, where is buildings and other structures may be located. Third, permits the types of buildings and how they can be used. And the last but not least, the maximum allowable dimensions of buildings and structures, as well as requirements for parking lots, heights and facades of buildings. So each of Canada's planning laws has five basic requirements. First, each municipality is responsible for preparing a general territorial plan, a general plan, sometimes called an official plan or a city plan. It sets out the main directions of the municipality's policy on the use of land located within it, usually include statements on social economy purposes of the community. Secondly, the official territorial plan is fixed by maps and written text containing the requirements of public organizations or the municipality, which are put forward to the rules of land use and development of districts, as well as guidelines for developing the potential of the municipality. Additionally, sets of plans of special areas located on the territory of the municipality can be developed. These are, for example, plans for the preservation of historical, cultural, or architectural heritage, the reconstruction of urban neighbors or industrial parks, and others. So the next one, the requirements of the Planning Act include legal norms and administrative mechanisms for the implementation of the general territorial plan, for example, land use rules, their zoning, management of apartment buildings, and procedures for obtaining building permits. Thus, in particular, before granting a building permit, the land plot must be pre-allocated, so zoned, simultaneously with compliance with the rules for the type of land on which the land plot is located, as well as the amount of available construction space and requirements for architectural features in the municipality. Okay, and next one, planning acts provide for cases of restrictions of the rights of private landowners, thereby ensuring the public interest, which includes the following main elements. So the first one is safety and health of people. Secondly, conveniences, services, and favorable environment for the population. Next one, accessible standards of private and public housing and jobs. And the last, a reasonable burden of state and municipal expenditures that should ensure the development of land. And as conclusion, I want to mention that according to Canadian law, zoning is a process of management procedures carried out by authorities aimed at land use, construction of buildings, structures, as well as improvement of land. And the main piece of legislation governing zoning is the 1983 Canadian Municipal and Planning Law. This act, inter alia, stipulates that zoning in Canada also performs a control function by the authorities over the proper use of land municipalities. So that's all for now. Thank you so much for your attention.
Bogdana, thank you very much. This was very useful and informative presentation.